after the riots broke out, I had gone to Luni in this relief camp in Ghaziabad. A lot of nurses there, they told me that a lot of women that they found had scars on their breasts and they were attacked with knives or swords on their breasts. One had to spend a lot of time for the women to actually trust me enough to open up, because a lot of women had not even told their family members that they had gone through sexual violence. Some of the women recounted where they said that the mob was loudly shouting and saying Muslimano ki londiyon ko rakh lo, or they would play dhol or DJ almost like celebrating their act of sexual violence against the women from this community. In Lakh Pabri, one of the villages in Shamli, which was one of the worst affected villages in the riots, they were told that they should go to the compound of the village pradhan, whose name was Pradhan. So Pradhan promised them that once they come to his house compound, they will be sheltered and there will be no violence against them. But as soon as they went inside, a mob arrived and they started thrashing and maiming and killing all the male members inside the compound. And they also started raping and brutally gang raping a lot of women, and they described what happened. 19 women were raped inside Pradhan's compound. Over the next few months, one found out that there have been several such cases, and close to 100 women were raped or gang raped during the riots. Shadow Lines was published in July 2014, which was about these seven women who had actually mustered the courage to go to the court and file cases of rape against their perpetrators. All these seven women were from Shamli or Muzaffarnagar district. All of them mostly worked as farm laborers in the fields of the accused. So like one of them recounted that while she was being raped by the Jat landowner whose field she used to work in, that person told her while raping her that you used to ask for your wages on time. So how dare you now, we'll show you what your station in life is, what your aukaat is. There was a clear class angle also, because security provided by the Supreme Court, the police was also from the same community as the accused. These women would go and try and file case or get some kind of information. The policeman accompanying them would go and inform the accused that this is the kind of testimony that they're going to give, and that would work against them. Also, the accused, because they were more powerful, socioeconomically well off than the complainants, they would often come and try to threaten them. In fact, one of the women in the seven people who filed the case, her son was actually threatened in the middle of a bazaar in Shamli, where a pistol was pointed at him and the woman was told, if you do not withdraw the case, we're going to kill him. And that is why, as of now, out of the seven cases, only one woman continues to fight her case and the rest of them have withdrawn. The political nexus behind this kind of communal riot was very responsible for making these women withdraw their cases and not seek justice or not want justice any longer, because they were so fed up with the process. Even now, when the new government has come into power in UP, now they're trying to withdraw cases against all the accused, generally in the Muzaffarnagar riots. An urban woman from an upper caste does get some kind of hearing in the court of law, but these Muslim working class women who are not so articulate in the way they say things, those women have completely been disappointed, and that says a lot about the kind of privileges even as a rape survivor one can have and one cannot. In in a political climate right now in this country where people are being lynched and there are hate crimes all across, this is not a good precedent where people now are beginning to believe that they have a free hand to kill anyone, rape anyone, or hurt anyone because you are from the majority religion and you can get away with it even if there's a police complaint against you. Then nothing's going to happen in the court and there will be no justice. So that, I think, is very dangerous and that should not go on.